Hello guys, welcome back to my channel once again. Today I'm super mega excited to be sharing this new content with you guys. So as we all know, or if you don't know yet, Fear Street is a four-part movie, and to be honest, I really like the first part of the movie. So I decided to watch the second part to see, you know, if it will keep the same motion, if it will be as good as the first. And to be honest, I'm really happy with it. So part two of Fear Street has come out, and even though this part it doesn't actually have the lesbian couple, there is the Cindy and her sister Ziggy that are like the main characters in this chapter of the movie. And to be honest, I really like the connection that they have with each other. So I decided to do a follow-up on part two because I really want to do regarding all the chapters. I was seeing that in chapter three, I think like the lesbian couple, they will start appearing back again, you know. I don't know, maybe let's see what's gonna happen. But I'm just here to speak a little bit about, you know, chapter two. And to be honest, I'm really like it, even though it ends really bad, like one of the sisters dies and it's very sad, but it's part of the movie. That's what the movie is actually about, you know. It's horror thriller and all of this stuff, so I ain't got anything to say about it. But it's a really good movie. I really like the direction that the writers and the creators are going with it. I'm really anxious to see part three and to see what's gonna happen. It's coming out very soon, and I will definitely recommend anyone to go watch it. You guys won't disappoint yourself. It's young, it's fun, and it's really good acting, and the quality of the movies are really good. So basically, one of the sister's boyfriends, he actually got possessed and he started killing everybody. And at the end of the day, the sister, they're trying to break the spell by go burying a hand that they found, but that end up not going their way, and they end up both getting killed at the same time. But then one survived because one guy that liked the other sister actually come and helped her, and she survived. And then after that, she tried to take her sister's identity, but it didn't happen that way because the guy told her real identity. And yes, and basically the whole story was four of them trying to break the spell, but it actually didn't go their way. And they were also going through a lot of family issues. They were about to lose their house, their mom started drinking a lot, their father left them, and they were just going through a lot, and they kind of separated them as sisters. But they had to go to this camp together, and things just wasn't going their way, you know. One of the sisters got bullied a lot, and the other one was trying to do the right thing by being a good person, by changing her way. Maybe then her things in her life would have changed, but it didn't go her their way because her boyfriend actually got possessed. So it was a whole thing going on. And at the end of the day, they reunited, they apologized to each other, and then they both died at the end of the movie, but then one survived, like I mentioned previously. So that's basically the storyline in the movie. I would definitely recommend anybody to go watch Fear Street part one and part two. It's really good. I know you guys won't get disappointed. And yes, it's just a nice young fun teen thriller horror movie, and you guys will like it. I like it, so I really hope you like it too. Yeah, so guys, that's basically it. Please don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel, and I will definitely be back with another video very soon.